One thing that I loved about many of the science fiction shows that I watched was that it showed that women, and even women of color, could be very prominent players in exploration and in scientific processes. And so I never doubted that there was a place for me in this kind of future because it was on the screen. And for me, it was a dream that seemed entirely achievable to be an active participant in science. From a very young age, the idea of exploring other worlds was already embedded in my brain. And one thing I really took away from watching and reading science fiction was the idea that other worlds could be habitable in terms of not just like alien life, but also in terms of humans moving outward and expanding into the rest of our solar system and perhaps even beyond. The fact that there was still another frontier that could be explored, that could be learned about, that was so compelling to me. And I wanted to be a part of that exploration. It just really excited me to my core. And once I was in college, I realized that there was this entire field where I could study rocks, not only from Earth, but also from other places and figure out the histories of planets. It was a no-brainer to me. But I'd never even been camping before. Like, it was just a cold, like, all right, I know this is what I want to do. I've never even taken a class in it, but my heart knows. And so I'm just gonna dive in. One thing that I think is really exciting about the present moment is I think in terms of understanding space, understanding the evolution of the planets, we're really at a turning point where space is becoming more accessible very quickly with the privatization of spaceflight. I'm participating in an investigation where a commercial company is going to land a rover on the moon with a magnetometer to study the moon's magnetic history. And it's from the knowledge that we gain from studying the rock samples that we can further understand the histories of the Earth and other bodies. And whenever we explore further, we have real contextual information. So I'm really looking forward to learning more about just fundamental planetary processes. How do planets work? How do they tick? How do they form? How do they evolve? By, you know, leveraging this new paradigm that we are entering in space exploration.